Hello everyone. In this module, we will cover our next important compounds of borone, that is boric acid, and the other compound that we will cover is borax. Moving on to the properties and preparation of boric acid, first of all, we will cover the preparation. Boric acid is prepared from borax by treating it with any acid in presence of water. The reaction here is mentioned below, that is Na2B4O7, which is the formula for borax. On treating with HCl in presence of excess water, gives NaCl plus H3BO3, where H3BO3 represents boric acid. Next is by hydrolysis of other borone compounds, like BCl3 on treatment with water gives BOH thrice, which is the other way in which we write boric acid, and it is H3BO3. It consists of 3 hydrogen atoms and 3 oxygen atoms. Therefore, it could be written in the manner that is BOH whole thrice. Next is on treatment of diborane with water, we get boric acid plus hydrogen gases liberated. Next is from the mineral of borone, that is colimenite. Colimenite Ca2B6O11 on treatment with sulfur dioxide in presence of water gives calcium sulfite, that is CaSO3 plus boric acid. Next is the properties of boric acid. First of all, it is a very good antiseptic, and because of its that properties, it is used in various antiseptic ointments and various antiseptic solutions. Next important feature is that it is a weak monobasic acid, that despite having 3 hydrogen atoms, it behaves as a monobasic acid only. Therefore, it is, and also it is not neutralized by any normal alkali such as NaOH. And therefore, it cannot be approximated by using the neutralization method, that is by simple acid-base titrations. Therefore, in case if we have to estimate boric acid by neutralization method, we add cis-diol in practice, where cis-diol consists of 2 OH group on adjacent carbons on the same site, or it is also known as vicinal diol. For example, ethylene glycol, it forms a ring compound in cyclic compound with borone, and then it can be neutralized, and its pH now comes in that particular range, and it can be neutralized by normal neutralization method on treating with the suitable alkali. Next is, it is used in eye washes and lens solution because of its good antiseptic property and its softness. Next is, the what are the effects of heating on the structure of boric acid? Boric acid, as I mentioned before, it has a simple structure of 3 OH groups attached to 1 borone atom. So when it is heated at 100 degree centigrade, it forms HBO2, that is one water molecule is removed, and HBO2 is metaboric acid. When we further heat this compound to 160 degree centigrade, it tetramerizes to form a compound, that is tetraboric acid, with the formula H4B2O7. It dimerizes basically with the removal of some water molecules. Next, on heating this compound up to 300 degree centigrade, we get B2O3, that is boron trioxide. Therefore, on heating boric acid on different temperatures, we can get different compounds such as metaboric acid or tetraboric acid or boron trioxide, starting from our initial compound, that is boric acid. Next, our next important compound is borax. Borax, it is a very important commercial compound of borone, and it has found many practical applications in different fields. First of all, we'll cover its preparation. It is prepared from colimenite, that is colimenite, the mineral of borone, Ca2B6O11, on treatment with sodium carbonate gives Na2B4O7 plus sodium borite NaBO2 plus calcium carbonate. When this sodium borite is treated with carbon dioxide, we get Na2B4O7, that is borax, plus Na2CO3. Any extra Na2CO3 or any carbonate impurity is removed from the solution, and this reaction is carried out multiple times, that is multiple times sodium borite is treated with carbon dioxide to form borax. Next is from orthoboric acid, that is on treatment of orthoboric acid with sodium carbonate, we get borax plus carbon dioxide gases released. Next is the structure of borax. In the structure of borax, boron atom is basically sp3 hybridized with three oxygen atoms attached to it and one OH group. Due to the presence of one extra OH group, boron has a negative charge on it. And in this structure, there are basically two sp3 hybridized boron atoms present, whereas the other two boron atoms are sp2 hybridized with a simple trigonal planar geometry, and the sp3 hybridized boron atoms have a tetrahedral geometry consisting of four bonds around it. Borax has a cyclic structure and it is represented by the formula Na2B4O5OH48 water. The four OH groups can be shown here clearly in this picture, and the presence of five normal oxygen atoms 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the presence of eight water molecules that are present as normal water of crystallization. Next is the properties of borax. The first and the most important properties of borax is that it is used for the detection of transition metals through a very common test, which is known as borax bead test. On heating, borax swells and it forms a glassy glass bead type structure, which consists of sodium borite and boron trioxide. That is, borax on heating at very high temperature, around 800 or 850 degrees centigrade, it gives NaBO2, that is sodium borite plus boron trioxide. And this particular compound, a mixture of sodium borite and B2O3, is known as bead, that is the borax bead. And this bead has a characteristic color for particular metal ion whenever it is treated with the solution of that particular metal ion. For example, when it is treated with a solution of copper sulfate, it forms a beautiful shiny blue colored bead, and hence it is used to detect the presence of copper in a particular salt. Next important application is that it is alkaline in nature. Because the acidic solution, the aqueous solution of borax, it gives BOH thrice, that is boric acid plus BOH 4-. Due to the presence of this negatively charged boron tetrahydroxy species, it is alkaline in nature, and moreover, the BOH thrice is a very weak acid. Boric acid is a weak monobasic Lewis acid, whereas BOH 4- is a strong base. Therefore, since the stronger base part is dominating, therefore its solution is majorly alkaline in nature. And due to its alkalinity, it is also used as a buffer solution. So these were the two compounds of boron that we discussed here, that is boric acid and borax. Borax has found much better and more practical applications as compared to other compounds of boron, especially in the field of inorganic chemistry, where the borax bead test is particularly used for the detection of various transition metals in a particular mixture of compound. And this formation of this glassy bead-like structure is the remarkable property of borax compound. Secondly, the boric acid, as we already saw, because of its properties, its very weak acidity, or we can say the alkalinity of its solution, it has found many applications in eye solutions, especially in eye washes, or we can say in eye drops as well, and especially in the solution that we use for contact lenses. The solution in which we kept it, it consists a major amount of boron compounds in it. And this was all about the chemistry of boron. The topics that we cover here is borax, boric acid, and in the first lesson we cover about diborane.